today to kind of take in what happened yesterday, but how fun was that? You know, just kind of finally feeling that maybe what you ended up last year.
No, it was fun to go out there and make plays, but, you know, it felt good since I've been out there, since the first game. I was just being out there with my teammates. It just felt good to be out there and win.
Could you feel any extra burst, you know, whether it's just excitement, energy, or what, in this game compared to some of the previous ones?
You know, when you go out there on that field, you see your fans out there, you get the same excitement for every game. You know, just going out there playing against LSU, getting a chance to go beat them for the first time, it was a great feeling to get a chance to beat them and get to play them at home.
How tough is it at Mississippi State when they start clanging those cowbells?
Oh, man, it's crazy. I hate them bells. Big fans being too. We just got to block that out and play our ball.
Is it the noise or is it just that it's a different noise?
What? Yeah, it's just a weird noise. You know, you don't expect crowds to do that, but they do it. And it's weird, but they like it, I guess.
So talk about first touchdown. You caught the ball about eight or so and just – like you milled your way in the end zone there?
It's just me finishing a play. You know, you get a chance to make a play. You see the end zone, your eyes get big. You just want to get in there. That's what I did. I just forced my way in.
How special is it to be part of this type of game? You're part of several of these high-profile games that the nation's watching. Is that pretty special to be a part of those?
You know, just go out there and show the world that we're trying to make a statement every time we go on the field. We get a chance to go against somebody like LSU, Mississippi State, you know, Arkansas, we got a chance to prove ourselves that we trying to go back to this championship. That's what we do every time we go out there on the field.
And you still feel like you guys have to do it,
yeah. You guys do a lot of noise work. I mean, starting the season, do those kind of moments help you guys when you go on the road with like
Houston
and silent?
Oh, you know, when I went to Kansas State, it was real. They fans was loud, you know, but it takes what we do at practice with the music. And the crowd knows we have a presence to help out a lot of folks and, you know, be on rhythm. And that's one big thing Coach Malzahn made sure we do.
Fanny, what was it with some of the overthrows, I guess, from Kansas State and some of that kind of stuff, where you were just fingertips away? I mean, what do you attribute to kind of just that little difference? Because you seem to make that up in this last one.
You know, it just, you know, missed opportunity for both me and Nick. You know, it's just one of the things that happened. You know, every quarterback have, every wide receiver have that. You know, it's just something you just got to go past and just look for the next play.
Does Nick turn it up another level when you go against an LSU or an Mississippi State?
Nick brings something special to the game every time he steps on that field. You never know what to expect from him. He's a playmaker. He's going to do something great every time he got the ball in his hand. That's what we like about him. That's all we play for him every time he goes on that field.
What is it about this game against Mississippi State that's made it so tough over these last few years?
You know, it's just Mississippi State. They're a great team. They come out there and give you their best every time. They're a physical bunch. And we got to go out there and just be prepared for what they're going to bring to us. We know they're going to come out fired up because they 5-0 and we 5-0. It's going to be one of them hard knocking games. We got to be ready for it.
What do you remember specifically about last year's game against them?
Oh, man, it was a physical game. They came prepared. They came playing. They bust off. They came to prove a point. They wanted to beat us, and we just had to fight our way to the end. It came down to the last play, and that's what we got to expect this game, because they're going to come with it at home.
Sammy, how much do you feel like your ability to stretch the field and really kind of expand the defense is going to help this offense expand as well? We saw it last night, but you haven't really seen it up till that point.
You know, this is one thing about our offense. You never know what to expect. You know, we can go deep, we can throw it short, we can run the ball on you. So it's just one of the things Coach Miles gonna bring out. You know, he gonna come out there with his game plan. He either gonna come out and run it on you, or he'll come out and throw it on you. We can do either one with Nick throwing the ball, the way he's throwing it, and the way we're running it, it's whatever.
Sammy, as he has the last two games now, scrambling around a lot back there, what does that do to two or four receivers?
You know, for us, you know, you see a quarterback can do that, get out the pocket and still make plays. It helps us out and help him out. You know, he still can make plays when he's outside the pocket, running around, throwing the ball 6 to 5 yards down the field. You know, just to keep our offense balanced and keep all the defense on their toes.
What do you do every day to try to make sure your knee is 100% on Saturdays?
You know, I just go to treatment every day. Even if I'm not hurt, if I'm hurt, I'm just going to treatment anyway. And there's one thing about playing football, you don't get nicked and bruised. You just got to keep getting treatment. What we do every day.
Do you feel like you're back to that speed we saw last season yet?
I'm getting out. Day by day process.
Sam, we talked to some of the other, your teammates after the game. They said that you've kind of been struggling a little bit. You want to contribute. You want to be a big part of the offense. And maybe physically you couldn't. Did you ever hurt this last few weeks trying to get back to that point?
You know, it's just like I go out there, I try to help the team out any way I can. If I can't run a deep route, I'm going to go out there and block my butt off. You know, it's one thing teammates do for each other. You're going to play for each other no matter what's going on with your body. You're just going to fight through it. That's one thing we learned as a team. We had to be tough, and that's one thing we talk about, toughing together. That's what I push through every day. I don't care if I'm hurting and pain, I'm going to go out there and just give them all.
Nick's a quiet guy, so maybe you wouldn't say it in these kind of words, but do you think he gets a little motivated when the other quarterbacks get in the hype, talked about so much, to kind of show what he can do as well?
Oh, man, I don't think Nick pays attention to anything outside of Auburn. You know, he's one of those guys that he brings us up. He's one of those guys that don't worry about him on the outside world. He just come out there and just be ready to play.
Your coach last talked about giving him more responsibility. You see him now, you know, signaling back to the sidelines, well, let's do this. Have you seen him take on more of that responsibility?
Nick's a great leader. He go out there and see what he sees with the defense. He got so smart back there. He knew what's going on. He read the defense good. He's doing a great job letting the coach know what we can run and what we can't run. And that's really helping our offense. It's helping Miles Dine and Coach Rhett a whole lot. So the way he's playing right now is unbelievable how much he ain't getting along from last year, just coming into the system.
How much does that give you guys confidence when you see your quarterback, you know, talk about, hey, this is what I need to do?
Oh, that's big. You know, he's one of those guys that, you know, when he sees something, he can make a play from it. You know, he see a guy on defense that can't stop him, he gonna make a play from him. You know, that's one kind of guy he is. He's just a playmaker, and we just build around him.
Sam, I wanted to ask you about Duke real quick. Obviously, a lot of emotions going into this last game. What did you see from him prior? You can kind of tell he was one of the last in the locker room after warm-ups and stuff like that. There was a lot of built-up energy for Duke, especially.
Duke, one of the guys that he get on that field is a new Duke. He one of the guys that got to be, he hungry. He go out there with an attitude that nobody can't stop. And that's what we learned from Duke when he first got here. If he make a mistake, it get to him real good, and he make up for it right behind it. That's the kind of fighter he is. That's what we like about him. He bring another spark to the offense. You know, it make everybody be more, work harder and do stuff because the way he work. And it's just something we take from him.
Sam, we've heard so much about the LSU second half last year, that being like the whole locker room thing, like we're not going to lay down, we're not going to quit, et cetera, et cetera. But do you think like this, the 88-yard, you know, the game-winning drive to Mississippi State, do you feel like that was maybe every bit as important just in the way that, I mean, who knows, if you guys, you know, lose that game, who knows how the rest of the season
goes? You know, like Miles going to say, we can be down, we can be up, you know, we just got to find a way to win at the end of the day. When we played against Mississippi State last year, we knew it was going to be a dog fight. We just had to go out there and find a way to win, and that's what we did. But LSU, when we lost that game, we never quit. We was going to find a way to win. We had a chance with our all-star kick. We didn't get it, and you know, it's just one of the things. We still fought to the end.
All right.
Thanks.
Thanks, Sam.